Now, News 8 Sports with Travis Lee.
Well, when Jay and Livermore Falls meet in football, it's always worthy of Game of the Week status. But this year takes on added meaning as the towns discuss merging the high schools. And there's a chance this could be the final meeting in the storied rivalry. On Friday night, the communities of Jay and Livermore will turn their attention to the gridiron, like they have for decades, for their annual matchup.
The night Jay plays Livermore, if you want to steal anything in these towns, that's the night to do it.
The communities know that tomorrow night, they could be writing the final chapter to their storied rivalry.
It's not only the last time for me, but it could be the last time for everybody to see, so it's kind of a memorable thing to be in it.
John Taglienti is part of the game's history. He coached Jay from 1952 to 1985.
Brings out the people of both communities, Jay and Livermore Falls. And the players really show a lot of sportsmanship throughout all the years I've been at Jay.
Ron Beatty, who coached at Livermore Falls from 1971 to 1998, says that sportsmanship is a byproduct of a unique relationship the towns share with youth sports.
Now, I guess in the old days, it was very, very bitter. And then in the late 60s, I believe, maybe 68, they put in youth sports. And the kids from Jay and the kids from Livermore all played together. So, you know, they'd be friends. These kids are all friends before they go to high school. They play Little League sports together.
We're good friends with each other from other schools because they're so close by. We actually, what it is, we grew up with them all through the years playing the AYS sports. And then we separate and we become the two teams, the Livermore Falls Annies and the Jay Tigers. And we see who's better than.
It's a rivalry that has been passed on from generation to generation. And each player seems to carry a little of the past into each encounter.
My mother has four brothers and they all played. They all played in the same game and they all won. So I wanna do it too.
Where it's potentially the last game, I mean, we're gonna play all out. And we'll be playing for the people of the past who played this game.
And both programs are kind of in a tough situation because they would love to commemorate the last game if they knew for sure it was the last game. We'll find out later on if it is indeed the last game after the season. And as usual, there are playoff implications on the line for that one. And we'll have all the highlights tomorrow night, Blitz 8 at 11.
All right, looking forward to it.